In this short video, we're going to go over some chemistry problems involving electrons, ion formation, and isotopes. So let's look at how we can use some of this information we've learned about electrons in order to answer some chemistry problems. So in our first problem, we're told that carbon has the atomic number of 6. How many covalent bonds can an atom of carbon make? Well, to answer this question, we need to understand some of the information provided in the problem. First off, since we're told that carbon has the atomic number of 6, this tells us that carbon has 6 protons and 6 electrons. The atomic number specifically tells us the number of protons of atoms of that particular element, and all atoms in their natural or elemental state are electrically neutral, meaning the number of positive charges is equal to the number of negative charges. What we can do is start filling in these electrons into the electron shells to see what the status of that outermost shell is. So in this case, all 6 protons are going to be found in the nucleus of carbon, so that very center. Then, our first electron shell has room for exactly 2 electrons. We always fill the first shell first before moving on to the second. So out of our 6 electrons, 2 of them go in the first shell, leaving us with 4 electrons remaining. These 4 electrons go into the second shell, a shell that has room for exactly 8 electrons. So we now see that carbon has 4 empty spots in its outermost electron shell. In order to make a covalent bond, carbon has to have an electron in that outer shell that it's willing to share in order to fill one of those empty spots in its outermost shell. Since there are 4 empty spots and 4 electrons in carbon's outermost shell, carbon is able to make 4 covalent bonds. Let's look at a new problem. Is sodium, which has the chemical symbol of Na and the atomic number of 11, more likely to become an anion or a cation? So a few things we need to understand in order to answer this question. So anions are negatively charged ions, whereas cations are positively charged ions. So how do we figure out if sodium is going to be a positive or a negatively charged ion? Well, again, to do this, we need to look at the electrons and the electron shells. So we're told that sodium has the atomic number of 11, meaning sodium has 11 protons and 11 electrons. All 11 protons show up in the nucleus of the atom. And now we start filling in the electron shells. The first electron shell can hold exactly 2 electrons. Leaving us with 9 electrons. The second electron shell can hold exactly 8 electrons. Leaving us with 1 electron. This 1 electron on its own has to go in the third electron shell, an electron shell that has room for 7 electrons. Now, there's no way for sodium to make 7 covalent bonds or somehow gain 7 electrons to become stable. But if sodium could just get rid of that 1 electron in that outermost electron shell, well, then suddenly it would be stable, it would be filled. So that's exactly what sodium wants to do. Sodium wants to get rid of one of its electrons. And if it does that, if it finds another atom that's willing to take that electron, well, then sodium would have 11 protons, because those are still in the nucleus and that's not going to change. But it will have 10 electrons. In this case, the number of positive charges will outnumber the number of negative charges, and so sodium is likely to become a cation, not an anion. Now, the final type of question I'd like to go over in this video has to do with isotopes. Isotopes are atoms of the same element, but which may have different mass numbers. So it's important to remember the difference between the atomic number and the mass number. The atomic number of an atom is equal to the number of protons. The mass number of an atom, and this is what's given in an isotope, is going to be the number of protons plus the number of neutrons. And so in this case, we're told that carbon-14 is an isotope of carbon. The 14 is the mass number. We're also told that carbon has the atomic number of 6. So how many neutrons are in an atom of carbon-14? Well, in this case, we know the mass number, we know the atomic number. We're trying to solve for the number of neutrons. So if we take our mass number and we subtract the number of protons from it, which in this case is 6, then our resulting number is the number of neutrons. So carbon-14, an atom of carbon-14 has 6 protons and 8 neutrons. Now that we've gone over these problems, I would like you to practice a few of these on your own. So nitrogen, it has the atomic number of 7. How many covalent bonds can an atom of nitrogen make? Is chlorine, with the atomic number of 17, more likely to become an anion or a cation? And oxygen-18 is an isotope of oxygen, which has the atomic number of 8. How many neutrons are in the nucleus of an atom of oxygen-18? Hopefully you'll be able to complete these types of chemistry questions based on the information that you've learned, because these are types of questions which you may see on future exams. With that, thanks for your attention, and see you in the next video.